सुस्वागतम विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, सायन्स अँड टेक्नॉलॉजी इयत्ता 8वी पार्ट 1 चॅप्टर नंबर 5 हीट। स्टूडेंट, वी नो द डिफरन्स बिटवीन हीट अँड टेम्परेचर। हीट इज वन ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी, इट इज थर्मल एनर्जी। टेम्परेचर इज नॉट अँड एनर्जी, इट इज थर्मल स्टेट ऑफ फिजिकल बॉडी। सो वी नो द ऑल पॉइंट्स अबाउट द डिफरन्स बिटवीन हीट अँड टेम्परेचर। हीट ट्रान्सफर इज अ रिझन बिहाइंड टेम्परेचर चेंजेस। टेम्परेचर व्हेरिएशन कॅन बी रिझल्ट ऑफ गेन ऑर लॉस ऑफ हीट अँड ऑदर द पॉइंट दॅट इज हीट इज नॉट अ फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मॅटर बट टेम्परेचर इज अ फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मॅटर। हीट इज अ पाथ फंक्शन अँड टेम्परेचर इज अ पॉइंट फंक्शन। सो दीज आर सम पॉइंट्स ऑर द डिफरन्स ऑफ बिटवीन हीट अँड टेम्परेचर। देन वी स्टडी अबाउट लॅटंट हीट। इन अन एक्सपेरिमेंट वी सी सम आईस क्यूब्स इन अ फ्लास्क अँड इट इज हीटेड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ बर्नर and temperature is recorded with the thermometer. So the temperature remains constant during this transition. This constant temperature at which ice convert into water is called the melting point. So during transition of solid phase to liquid, the object absorb heat energy but its temperature does not increase. This energy is utilized for weakening the bonds between atoms or molecule in the solid and transfer it into liquid phase. The heat energy absorbed at a constant temperature during transformation of solid into liquid is called as a latent heat of fusion. The amount of heat energy absorbed at a constant temperature by unit mass of a solid is called as a latent heat of fusion. Once all the ice is transferred into water, the temperature of water get rising. It increases up to 100 degrees Celsius. In graph, line BC represent rise in temperature of water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. Thereafter, even though heat energy is supplied to water, its temperature does not rise. The heat energy is absorbed by water at this temperature and used to break the bonds between molecules of liquid and convert liquid into gaseous state. Thus, during transformation from liquid phase to gaseous phase, heat energy is absorbed by the liquid, but its temperature does not change. The constant temperature at which the liquid transforms into gaseous state is called as a boiling point of liquid. The heat energy absorbed at a constant temperature during transformation of liquid into gas is called as a latent heat of vaporization. So, the amount of heat energy absorbed at a constant temperature by unit mass of a liquid to convert into gaseous phase is called specific latent heat of vaporization. So, we study what is actually meant by latent heat and latent heat, specific latent heat of fusion and specific latent heat of vaporization. Different substances have different melting points and boiling point. The value of melting point and boiling point and latent heat depends on atmospheric pressure. Next topic is regelation. What is actually mean by the regelation? We have seen an experiment in which ice slab is situated and a thread with weighing is on the ice slab. After some time, the wire or the thread comes out of a lower surface of ice slab. However, the ice slab does not break. The phenomenon in which ice convert to liquid to applied pressure and then reconvert to ice once the pressure is removed is called as a regelation. The melting point of ice become lower than 0 degree Celsius due to pressure. This means that at a 0 degree, the ice get converted into water. As soon as pressure is removed, the melting point is restored to 0 degree Celsius and water get converted into ice once again. So it is very simply explained that the phenomenon in which ice converted to liquid due to applied pressure and then reconvert to ice once the pressure is removed is called as a regelation. Our next topic is anomalous behavior of water. When liquid is heated up to a certain temperature, it expands, and when cooled, it contracts. Water, however, shows a special and exceptional behavior. If we heat water from 0 degree Celsius up to 4 degree Celsius, it contracts instead of expanding. At 4 degree Celsius, its volume is minimum due to contraction. If the water is heated further, it expands and its volume increases. The behavior of water between its temperature of 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius is called anomalous behavior of water. If 1 kg of water is heated from 0 degree Celsius, its volume is plotted as a function of temperature. We get the graph as shown in the figure. The volume of water is minimum. It means that the density of water is maximum at the 4 degree Celsius. That is the graph. At 4 degree Celsius, the volume become very low, but density is very high of water. We can study the anomalous behavior of water using Hope's apparatus. Hope's apparatus is used for the study of anomalous behavior of water. The anomalous behavior of water can be studied with the help of Hope's apparatus. In Hope's apparatus, a flat blow is attached to a cylindrical container. There is provision to attach thermometer above it. The measure of temperature is T2 and below the measure of temperature is T1. The flat blow on the cylindrical container, water is filled in the cylindrical container and a mixture of ice and salt is put in the flat blow. During the study of anomalous behavior of water using Hope's apparatus, temperature T1 and T2 are recorded after each 30 seconds. The temperature is plotted on the y-axis and time in the minute on x-axis. The graph is shown in the figure. The graph shows that initially both the temperature T1 and T2 are identical. However, as the time passes, temperature T1 of water in the lower part of the cylindrical cylinder decreases fast, while temperature T2 of water in the upper part of the cylinder decreases comparatively slowly. However, once the temperature T1 of the lower part of reaches to 4 degree Celsius, it remains almost stable at that temperature. T2 decreases slowly to 4 degree Celsius. Thereafter, since T2 start changing rapidly, it records 0 degree Celsius first, and after that the lower thermometer T1 record 0 degree Celsius temperature. The point of intersection of the two curves are shown the temperature of a maximum density. So that is the Hope's apparatus in which we can study the anomalous behavior of water. At the above it is T2 thermometer and at the lower it is a T1 thermometer. However, we can explain this observation. Initially, the temperature of water in the middle of cylinder lowers due to the freezing mixture in the outer blow. Since the temperature of water there decreases, its volume decreases and its density increases. the water with higher density moves downward. Thereafter, the lower thermometer T1 shows the rapid fall in temperature, and this continue till the temperature of water become equal to 4 degrees Celsius. When the temperature of water starts decreasing below 4 degrees Celsius, its volume increases and density decreases. Therefore, moves in upward direction, the temperature of water in the upper part therefore decreases rapidly to 0 degrees Celsius. The temperature of water in the lower part T1 however remains at a 4 degrees Celsius for same time and then decreases slowly to 0 degrees Celsius. So that is the curve at which T1 rapidly decreases to 4 degrees Celsius and T2 however slowly shows the change in temperature. So aquatic animal in cold region have survived due to this region because water shows the anomalous behavior. The anomalous behavior is that if water heat from 0 degrees Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius, it contract instead of expanding. 4 degrees Celsius, its volume is minimum, and if water is heated further, it expand and its volume increases. The behavior of water between its temperature from 0 degrees Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius is called anomalous behavior. So due to this reason, the aquatic animal can survive in the cold region.